Hey. Hi everybody, Trevor here for Alan's Music Centre in Great Yarmouth for our regular show. Let me make sure I've got my buttons pressed okay over here. Oh, it's all very high tech and complicated. Here we go. Right, press the right one there. Brilliant. Hi everybody. Welcome to our Tuesday afternoon show. I was meant to be joined by my colleague Tom. So I have an empty chair next to me. In fact, he was supposed to be sitting in this chair and I was supposed to be having a rest in that chair. But he's busy with somebody on the shop floor, so he will join us in a little bit later on. So we'll get started today. So we are broadcasting live from our showroom in Great Yarmouth with our regular 3 o'clock show on... It's 3 o'clock, isn't it? Yes. On Tuesdays, where we get to present some of the wonderful instruments that we have in our showroom. And... we're back on the Wersi this week. We had, the lovely instruments we've been playing recently have all gone to their new home. So the Pergamon's gone to its new home. The Showcase has gone to a new home. And so we've had this one, this wonderful instrument come in, which is a Wersi OAX800. It's a very new one. It's running Windows 11. But what's unique about it is it's in this beautiful walnut mahogany wooden finish. So all of the Wersis we've normally been showing people are obviously in the white or the black. And of course you can have different colors, but they're all in a shiny finish, as it were. So it's lovely to have one actually in the wooden finish. And I think this looks really neat with a brown panel to match it as well. So it's a very, very good looking organ. So we took this one in part exchange. And so we thought, oh, immediately, let's get this on the show. Because I think somebody's already in the comments has said in the picture, there's no pedals. Yeah, because I was in such a rush to get the picture, I hadn't even put the pedals on yet. But yeah, lovely to have this here. So this is a beautiful Wersi OAX800. And well, loads of people on the chat already today. Wow, fantastic. Hi, Derek Sanders. Good afternoon, Trevor. And all watching today, looking forward to an informative and fun show. Hope everybody is well. Yes, we're all good here. We're all happy. Looking forward to Easter, which is early this year, isn't it? My children are very excited about the fact that it's early because it means that they've had a short term this Sunday in school. Hi from Ernie in Cedar Falls. Barbara Kefford, good afternoon, Trevor and Tom. Oh, nice to see you on the Wersi today, but when are you going to be on a 900? Well, it's us having a 900 in stock at the moment. We've actually got a couple of 800s. We've got this one in the mahogany finish, but we also have a white one coming in tomorrow as well. So it's a bit of we're 800 fest, as it were. What a beautiful instrument. Greetings from stormy Austria from Gunther. Oh, dear. Yeah, it's there's a bit of a swirling storm around Europe at the moment, isn't there? So lots of showers over Easter. Neville Jolly, hello everybody from Dull Durham City, looking forward to a treat from Tom and Trevor. Yeah, Tom will be here later. Dentist beckons first, oh dear. Bill, we'll not make this afternoon, catch up later, have a great session. Thank you, Bill. David Hartong, it's starting to look like spring in Ohio, your program put spring in our lives. Thank you, oh, thank you. Paul Denny, good afternoon on this glorious sunny day in Sandylands. Kev Wilcox, a quick question, can you please show me where to touch to get the hold option up as I couldn't get it on the other day, thanks. Oh, okay. We'll come back to that one. Wayne Lux, good afternoon, Trevor and Tom. Graham Williams, good afternoon, everybody. I'm wondering where the pedalboard is on the photo. Yeah, I saw that one. Good afternoon for the two T's. Well, one T at the moment, the big T, but we will have another big T with us in a bit. Philip Russell, good afternoon from Hemel-Hinston. Gary from Canada. Well, he's jumped down to the bottom again. Stephen Vandenborough. David from Sunny Penzance, Propulsor, Keith Rose, good afternoon, Trevor and Tom, Douglas Watts, hi Douglas, Tom Hendricks, Tim Jarrett, Lawrence Easdale, looking forward to learning more about the 800, yes Graham, Venture trying hard, watch his space, good afternoon Trevor, and empty chair Tom, yes, I should have brought my Tom in my pocket to put there today, good afternoon Trevor and Tom, greetings from Leeds, West Yorkshire for Alan Robinson and Philip Russell, splitting the keyboard with the OAX800 is better to split the keyboard in the middle and transpose the lower split up and the upper screw split down, Yeah, so we're splitting the keyboard with the OAX800 is better to split the keyboard in the middle and transpose the lower split up and the upper split lower, or split the keyboard at 2/3 and just lower the top. Yeah, I mean, there's all kinds of possibilities on that. Philip, we can have a look at that. So what did we open up with? We opened up with our little Patreon theme, and we were using a nice clarinet sounder. Actually, we were doing some presets for this earlier, and it's quite good fun because it's a kind of cheeky little song, so I thought the clarinet kind of fitted that. And we're using a great style on here. This is one of the the swing styles. We haven't got a shot of the screen of this at the moment, but this is called the Swing It Plus, and it's a, because it's a plus style, it means that the drums are live. They're recorded from a live drummer doing it, so they have much more natural kind of feel to them, especially with those kind of brushes. And what I love is on the fourth variation, the D variation, you even get a little drum solo. Which is great fun to play along with. So yeah, that's a nice little opening song. That's what we're doing on there. So Kath's question was about the hold button. I'm guessing when you said hold, there's the screen hold, which Ulrich changed the name of. So normally on the Wersis, if you select a sound, be it violin and so forth, and you don't choose anything while that screen is up there, it fades away gradually, which you can't see because I haven't got a camera on here on the screen at the moment. I had it for Tom, you see, to look at his empty chair. But normally, if that's the one you're missing, they don't call it hold anymore. They changed the name on, I think it was on 2.9, and they called it choose, so that if you have to choose on. So I'm guessing that that's the one you were looking for, Kath. So maybe you could confirm that in the chat. But the hold for the screen is now called choose, and you need to turn choose on rather than hold on. Hold on, hold on, is that a song? And choose on, yes. So yeah, Philip's statement about the split point. So there's an interesting thing you can do with the split point on the Wersi. And again, this was 2.91 introduced. Whereby you can ask for a split when you're using a sound to style. So let's put a sound to style type rhythm on. What should we use? Let's do a bit of a swing rhythm. Let's find a swing one that we're playing on there. Let's do that one. Yeah, let's swing. You don't do a lot of big band and swingy stuff on the Wersi. So one of the things you can do on the Wersi is that if you've chosen that style, you can have four what they call sound to styles. But you can also choose for those sound to styles to include a split. And this is actually this is kind of Philip's point that he said, is that when you split the keyboard in the middle or further down here to give you a longer range up here, because you've got these wonderful 276 note lovely keyboards, he actually automatically set it so that the left hand sound is raised an octave, so that you don't get it growling if you want to play the chords more comfortably in the left part of the keyboard there. Let me show you what I mean. So if we go normally to a sound to style, what have we got there? Yeah, got a bit of piano there. Yeah. So at the moment there's no split on the lower keyboards, so we've got a string sound down there, and I'm playing my string sound in the normal place. Actually, we had somebody query this in the shop the other day about where you should play the chords on the organ. And because they'd have a Lowry organ, they'd always play the chords down there, and they were mystified that why would you play them up here? Well, actually, strictly speaking, that's where you should play them. That's where the middle C is, and that's where the chords sound right. But for comfort, a lot of the time on the modern instruments, we play our chords an octave lower and raise the pitch by an octave so it doesn't sound growly, because normally when you play chords down there, very growly. So if we turn on the feature, which is the split for the sound to style, and we do that by holding down the total presets button or word at the top of the screen. And there's an option on here that says STS split. And there's also a choice where you want it to be. It's on F sharp 3 at the moment. So 1, 2, 3, I don't mind it being there. Now what that means is now when I go to a sound to style, if we go back to that piano one, it's a piano pop, great one. If I come down here, I've now got a split sound, but also my chords down here have automatically been raised an octave. So I can play a chord down here more comfortably and have this bigger split. So it's a really nice idea that Ulrich's actually, what Philip was just saying, he's actually already incorporated that into Sound to Style. So if we put a style on, so when you're using the Sound to Style with the split on, you get the split lower keyboard. Also, as Philip was saying, it takes the lower manual there, or the lower half of the lower manual, and raises it up an octave automatically so that you can... Are you right there, Tom? You made for a grand reveal. You need to sit a bit closer to be on camera.
Oh, I see. Well, I didn't want to intrude, you know. It's fine.
We've all been missing you.
I know.
There we
Sorry,
go.
Sorry, I'm
Tom
back.
Tom has joined us. Wait.
Yay.
Hello.
Yes.
Oh,
greetings.
Chatty cam.
Better.
There we
Hi.
Go.
Sorry about that.
Tommy's here.
I couldn't get the lid off my yogurt.
So after 2 weeks of being stuck with me, waffling and playing, people have been desperate. Where's Tom?
I don't know. There's 115 people for you.
I know. That's yeah. I've got a following now. See,
you have.
See,
you don't
we
need
can,
me.
We can now. There's no pressure, Tom. You know, if it drops off at all now.
Hang on, 15? 15? Oh, God.
Yes. Oh, no, the dislikes have started falling
in. Hello, everyone. Welcome, greetings, felicitations and all that. Yes, hello.
Yes.
Oh, and we're playing this wonderful
Wersi. We're playing the 800. I've introduced this beautiful wooden instrument.
Oh.
And I was just demonstrating an idea that Philip Russell said about, you know, when you've got these big lower keyboards, you can split them.
Yes.
And then the left hand, you know, you can raise that up an octave, so you can then play chords in a more comfortable position down there. And I was saying, actually, that's what's already in the Sound to Styles. Ulrich already thought of that.
Absolutely. So providing you switch it on.
Well, yes. We found that, yeah. We found how to switch it on as well. So, so we've kind of whizzed through a lot of the chat. How far do we get up to?
Philip Russell, Ken Purcell, yep. Hello, Ken. Media Century, Tom McCauley, and Propulsar says, look out behind you. That might have been my entrance.
You're arriving. He's behind you.
That will soon be coming up.
Excellent.
Yes, wow.
I was just waiting for Kath, because Kath had a question about couldn't find a hold, and I was just saying, well, it's now called Choose. So
Choose
I just
on,
wanted
yes.
to confirm if that's the one that she was looking for.
Ah, right.
There we go.
David from Prenzan says, this would also match my park furniture. Tom is trying hard, watch this space, yes? Hello, David. Yes. Well, some lovely sounds there as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, really nice. Well, I was also going to do a bit of playing.
Do that.
Yes, you do.
You do that.
I was going to do, what I've actually loaded into this organ, and don't worry, Tom, I didn't go over the ones you did earlier.
No.
That's a real danger when you have organs in the shop and multiple people are playing them, is that somebody would be doing all their work on it and whatever, and then somebody come along and say, oh, I'll put my stuff in there.
I'll put my stuff
all
in
their
there.
Work's gone. But I did save your stuff
that.
First.
Don't do that, yes.
I was doing a little I was fiddling around because I'm working on finally compiling the best of Patreon 2.
Oh, yes, of course.
Which is a great way of demonstrating all the wonderful sounds that these Wersis do. And also, it's a good way of testing my memory to see if I can remember these registrations that I made 6 months ago, if I can remember where, how I'm supposed to be playing them. And this one, actually,
Go on.
You have this as well, Tom, I'm sure. When you come back to something that you did a while ago,
yes.
You're sitting there going, oh, I did that. Oh, that was good.
That was good.
Or what did I really do that? Or what was I thinking?
What was I thinking? What was that for? Yes.
So I was playing through some of these today.
Oh, lovely. I'm going to go back to keyboard cam.
And I was thinking, yeah, I'm quite happy with that. And so I was... especially sometimes the choice of style. So, oh, I found that style, that's a good style. On the track, remember this show? Remember this show, Tom?
I'm trying to think what it's from. It's on the tip of my tongue. I know this song. Beats rather.
Simon May song, Howard's Way.
Howard's Way.
Yeah.
And then he said on Golden Pomp.
Been playing that for a long time.
Thing.
Yeah, very similar.
Yeah, yeah. So it's a TV theme. Yes.
Good fun piece of music that, going back a long time. I mean, must have been the '80s, really.
Yes, must have been. Oh, actually, Kath Wilcox. Hello, Kath. Has just put on. No.
Oh.
Not the Chews. It's the one where you can hold the style. I think you touch the top of the screen.
Yes. So you hold. Yeah. So yeah. Actually, it's the same place that we were looking at for the splitting the sound to style.
Ah.
Okay. So where it says the word total presets at the top of the screen. Mm. If you've got Music Archive, it will say Music Archive at the top. So if you do touch it once, it toggles between Total Presets and Music Archive.
Yes.
But if you have the Total Presets one on, and you touch the word Total Presets and you hold it, rather than just tapping it, so there's a difference between a tap and a hold.
Yes.
And then you'll see the option that we were just talking about earlier, the STS split.
Yep.
And also this idea of holding over the lower manual. Mm-hmm. So you can actually hold the lower manual sound as you go through presets and mm-hmm. the pedals.
Yep.
And also accompaniment hold.
Okay.
So you can then hold the accompaniment while you go through presets. So if you find a registrations that you like, but you don't like the style that it has, this is what Yamaha first called the disable button.
Yes.
So you could lock the style,
the
classic D button that they everybody were very excited about, and then they brought a whole range of organs out that didn't have it.
Yes, that's right.
It was so funny. It's like the simplest, brilliant idea that you could lock the style and go for all your presets.
Right, yeah.
And then they brought out the H series of instruments.
They didn't have it on.
And they didn't have a disable button. This is like, you invented it. The next series had it. But so you can hold the accompaniment. We could do a little quick demonstration of that. So
that's
we've got
great,
this great style on here. I like this style. What's this one for? I changed songs.
Right.
So we've got this beautiful, and this is a nice one. It's called Vocal Ballad Plus. It's using the live drums as well.
Mm.
So say I like that style, but I want to keep it as I go through different presets. So let's see, hold down the total presets. Oh, damn it. Hold it down. Got to do the right. Do it properly myself now. Do accompaniment hold and say pedal. Let's hold the left hand as well. So I can now keep this style. It's got this kind of belly thing. But I think actually no. Somewhere else I've got a nice oboe. So I want to go here, find my oboe, and I can still go to this oboe. and keep the stile locked. I've got all the laying this stuff in my head still. Isn't that a lovely string?
That's lovely.
Now, I went to a production of Les Mis last week, put on by a high school. And it was absolutely incredible. Absolutely blew me away.
Really?
That these sort of between 14 and 18, they put on a complete
production
of Les Mis. And even had me tearing up at the end. It was
excellent.
Absolutely quite amazing.
Chat has become a flurry.
Oh, sorry, yes, go on.
It has.
I'll do some background noise.
That's all right. Tim Jarrett, Lydia on the lounge, she said, I would love to have a Wersi sitting next to my Aria Pro. Is there a dealer close to Missouri? And Gary has said, of course, Jim Bogleman does Wersi in the US. Yeah.
Send us a commission.
Yes. Tom McCauley says, Vocal Ballad might work well with Chariots of Fire.
Yeah.
I was thinking that. Yes, it did have that sort of sound to it. Kath Wilcox says, thank you so much, Trevor. Perfect.
There was one actually I found here that I'd done at Christmas time, and I did bring the music. This is, while I've been working on editing these presets, I had to find the music for them all because I couldn't remember how to play the songs.
How they all went.
So there was one that we did at Christmas, even though it's not actually a Christmas song, but it was released at Christmas, so it became a Christmas
song.
Mad World. I found a great rhythm for that one. Again, it's nice to do some rhythms that are kind of a bit different.
Yes.
And I got, you know, and not always just your normal dun. And so let me take the lock off because that's going to stop it changing.
Scandal.
Isn't that smart? I remembered that.
You did. That's very good.
And so we came up with this lovely spacey kind of feel to it.
That sounds brilliant. Fantastic.
And then we have this brilliant rhythm that comes in. And it's just great having something a bit different. And do you know what this one's called?
Go on.
Because, you know, I am hip.
You are.
You know, I'm obviously well in with the youth of today.
This is it.
This is the Radio Dubstep Plus.
Oh, steady on.
Bit of dubstep.
Steady
you know, you
on.
Can't go wrong with a bit of dubstep, you know. Yeah, it's the Alan's Music Massive here.
Yeah, East Side.
Well, yeah, we are on the east side.
We are, yeah. That's a brilliant sound. Nice. Oh, yeah. That's great.
Brilliant fun.
Brilliant stuff.
All from our Patreon.
Enjoyed
Plus.
That.
Patreon, best of Patreon part two that's coming on.
Two. Yes.
On this beautiful OAX800.
Yeah.
It's just a joy to play.
Really nice. Yes, excellent. Well done.
Yeah, hey, thank you.
Yes. our American friends are chatting about Wersi's in America.
Yep.
Catherine Wilcox says, thank you, Trevor. Perfect. Stacey Ann H has just joined us from a cold and rainy northeast lower Michigan.
Stacey.
Oh, hello. Yep. And
it's generally raining in most places.
Chatty, chatty. Yes, absolutely. I think we're due some rain here today, aren't we, as well?
Indeed, yes.
Yes. Paul M says, did Wersi start making Thomas organs for a while?
No.
Thomas.
You know what, I mean, I'm not an expert on this by any means, so I could be completely and utterly wrong about this.
Aha.
It wouldn't be unusual, really.
Not like you.
But I think between the DX and there's one series of Wersi before they came up with the OAS system.
Yes,
where they made a particular style of organ. They're called Apollo. No, not Apollo.
Oh, the Apollo. Yes,
the Phoenix.
Yes, the Phoenix. Phonics.
Which was a very unusual design of instrument, and it had a matrix LCD touchscreen.
That's right.
And it was very much, it almost felt like a stopgap, really. Mm. And so they produced this organ, and I know, is that when they stopped making that one, all the old parts were bought up by somebody who then rebranded it as Thomas.
Yes, because Thomas was an American.
Old fashioned, but traditional organ make in America.
Yeah.
And so I think it's the other way around, that the Wersi version came out first. It was called the Phonics. Mm. And actually, it was a neat looking organ.
There's a lot of portable things in that version of it,
and the home version had this lovely wooden cabinet.
Yeah. Yeah.
And we sold quite a few of them. A very compact instrument.
Yes, very small.
Say, when it finished, I'm sure what they had left over as parts was sold to somebody who started calling them Thomas. And I think there might even be a Brazilian link to it.
Possibly,
somebody in Brazil doing it.
Maybe.
But
Thomas organs were made in Chicago. They used to be on TV years ago.
Thomas is a classic name.
Yeah,
big name. And that's why I think somebody was using these parts and using the name of Thomas to bring it back.
Okay.
As we've said so many times before, part of the problem for manufacturing organs is the cost of making the parts that you need, because you're not making them in sufficient quantity.
Mm.
So rebranding, as it were. Was a Wersi instrument, as a Thomas instrument, was obviously a good thing to
Something that they did, yes.
But I could be completely wrong on that.
Interesting. Yeah, I remember the Phonics a long time ago.
It was a very good organ.
Because I think it was one of the early ones. Actually had a touch screen, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was a matrix touch screen, so you kind of, and it beeped, I think, when you touched it.
That's right, yeah.
do you know that there was a particular style on that I used to love playing?
Yeah.
It was like a disco one.
Okay.
I'm not going to recreate it on here, I don't think, but. It was like a really fast disco.
Possibly.
Maybe one of these. And I used to play, I can't remember what the song is called now. I used to put on the classic kind of, classic Wersi sound.
Mm.
Let me find the sound right.
There was a settings menu.
Bear with.
That's the thing. That's there we're talking.
Yeah, so it used to be a... Really recognise this.
I know the beats, yeah.
And I used to get very excited because I would just use the transpose and do it all again.
Yeah.
Back,
yeah, I remember that piece. Yeah.
It feels like da, I'm in da, love. Da, da,
cha, cha, cha.
Somebody will know on the chat.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Well, amazingly, since I've come, it's gone up to 127.
Wow.
Or it's your choice of
tunes.
You
brought in your fan club.
Both, yes. Yes, David's
here. You're on the mobile phone
David Billingham must be on. David Billingham's on his phone and his iPad and his laptop all at the same time to bring the numbers up.
Come on, lads. Come on, lads. Get online now.
Right, everyone, and press it now.
Now, go.
Yes, that's it. Yeah. Well, that's great. Yeah, well, yeah. I was having great fun earlier playing this. Yeah.
Should we swap over? Because you haven't played for 2 weeks.
No, I
and
haven't.
And I did put your ONOY presets back in.
Yes, you keep sending me away, but I keep coming back. Yes.
Should we swap over?
We could do that. So should we do that?
Da, 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 da. We get all tangled up with each other.
Turn the microphone down so we don't make a great bang.
Yes. You go under.
I'm under. There we are. Oh, God. Too old. This moving around. I'm here.
Hey.
I'm all right. I'm in.
You're in. You're sorted.
I think
hello, everybody.
It's got to
there we go.
Get dressed.
There we go. So we're having a bit of a change. There we go. Yep. Kelly Marie feels like I'm in love. It was.
Yeah. God, I'm here. Right.
Ooh. Oh, there. And somebody says you were correct, Trevor, about the old Wersi being bought by Thomas Europe. There we go.
There you go.
I was actually right about something.
That's change.
Reveling this one.
Yes, absolutely. We are indeed.
Oh, there we go, Tom.
Oh, hello, minor four.
Oh.
So shall I elaborate or just play something?
Well,
there's no questions.
Play some nice music, yeah.
Shall I give a sneak peek to some of the... The Patreon. You haven't heard these noises, have you? Yeah. Okay, we'll do this then.
Let's have a listen. So we don't do much big band on the Lowry, so it's quite nice.
Sorry?
We don't do much big band on the Lowry. So.
Wersi. Thank you.
Wersi. No, sorry.
Ooh. Technical difficulties. Shut up.
Steady.
Thank you. Yeah, that's nice. That's nice, isn't it?
So it's lovely here in the Wersi doing some big band stuff.
Yes, that's right. Yeah. Coming soon to a Patreon video near
well,
you.
Well, Davey's just said I watched Tom's Patreon video on this an hour ago, and it's well worth watching.
It's already on there.
Yeah. I've got it up there. Yeah.
Yeah, but we haven't done the
the presets yet.
That's no, the next one.
Yeah. So we're talking about the music.
Give me half an hour. Yes. And that actually was good because That's what Trevor always says before he blacks out. What happened? You argued with me, darling.
Yeah,
that's right. Even I discovered some new sounds that I didn't know were in Wersi Sonics.
Yeah,
that's the beauty of it.
That is the thing is that we keep discovering.
I found
the beauty of the hobby.
Miller Brass 1, Miller Brass 2, and I was using Wersi chord. Yeah. So and actually, this thing on the lower key was the alto sax section.
Yeah, I used that actually. I was because of the little patron fiend I was mixing up with some big band, and actually that saxophone works really well.
Actually, you really hear all the parts there.
This is really nice. I mean, it's funny actually. We've always kind of associated the Larrys with the big band sound.
Freudian
slip earlier.
Indeed, yes.
but the Wersi actually is very good. So I think it's because we haven't really done much, have we? So we should need to do big band pack maybe.
Maybe I was thinking.
Yeah. See, Tom just gets started getting carried away now.
Yeah, a bit of vibraphone.
Yeah,
yeah. And most importantly, changing the pedal voice to an actual acoustic.
Proper acoustic bass, not using the...
Not the pedal bass.
Pedal bass.
No.
Yeah, because that tends to be the default pedal all the time. And so you don't get that right sound. Yeah. Kay, actually, Kai Sound Engine in Germany, asked which style did you use?
There were multiples. I started off with slow swing.
Okay. This is a really good point. A lot of people don't think about changing the style while you're playing.
While you're playing. Just leave it on the same rhythm. Boom, boom. So slow swing. And then I went to slow brushes audio.
Ah.
And then I finished with big band swing Miller.
So actually, so that freedom, staying away. three different styles.
But also, as I was playing there, even though I had the first three on the same style, I was using different variations. So for variety's sake.
There we go.
So slow swing variation B. That's got that noise, because big band music is very, very cymbal-led.
Yeah.
Steady.
Do you know the other thing? When you watch jazz drummers, I always kind of feel a bit sorry for them, because they never get to hit the drums very much.
He's always kind of like...
ting, 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 and then they hit the snare just like one offbeat, and then the bass drum maybe once in like 16 bars.
Yeah.
And you know, when you see rock players, they get to
really
bash the hell out of the drums. But the jazz drummers, they have to ting, 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 ting. You know, so it's all very subtle stuff.
It is subtle. It is very cymbal led. So there's variation B. So that's doing its thing, and occasionally a little bit tom tom.
Tom tom in there. Yeah.
Then variation. Now, was that A or was that C?
What was nice on there is hearing the stereo, because that tom-tom
came out. Yeah, absolutely.
Or maybe I'm going deaf in the other ear, but it came out one side.
And then variation A, which is subtle. They're very subtle changes. Then we have the audio style, which has a little bit more of a bass drum coming in. And then big band swing Miller, which has a bit more of the... snare thing, but the snare is just if you see a traditional snare drummer, they tend to play in the Jenny Mobile. I can't sorry. and the old fashioned way of playing was having the snare on the side, and it was just it's very very much cymbal led swing music. Yeah, so I changed that and a key change at the end, and so that's going to be exciting.
Yeah, I mean that's the nice thing about styles nowadays, they are so much more realistic.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, funnily enough, I remember when Yamaha brought out, I think it was on the HX again, when they took away the disable button, they started doing real swing rhythms.
Yeah.
So the swing section just went ting, ting, ting. And everyone was like, well, that's a bit rubbish, you know. It's like there's nothing there, because we were so used to having styles that went and it was really refreshing and much more realistic to have that kind of drumming going on.
If you put on like US cooking jazz, there's bits of stuff going on there. If you go to variation B, just ever so often little tiny accents
Yeah.
But all about that cymbal.
Yeah. No bass drum in there at all.
No.
You know, not this dum dum dum.
No.
Yeah. Philip says, Tom, no music for the big band on Patreon. There's notes and keys, but not one to change the setting. That video is coming.
On its way. Bear with.
Kai Stanley said, great idea. I haven't thought of changing the styles in the song face.
Incredibly important.
Yeah, I mean, we tend to get locked into this idea that, yeah, you've got the four variations, so that's the one you're moving. It's on any instrument, whether or not you're on the Wersi, the Lowry, the Ringway,
anything.
Don't be felt that you're locked in. And also, a thing that, funny enough, that Jim Vogelman had been mentioned earlier. One thing that Jim Vogelman was really good at is that not using the style all the way through.
Yeah, stopping.
You know, stopping the style and then playing free and then bring the style back in. Because again, you don't need necessarily, if you listen to an orchestra or a big band, they don't necessarily have the drummer going all the way through.
It gives those bigger, you know, especially if you have a break. It brings it in. Yeah, definitely.
Absolutely. So there's all kinds of things where you don't just have to think along those kind of train tracks of put a style
absolutely.
On and play with it all the way through.
Yeah.
There's all kinds of things that you can do.
Exciting.
There we go. So we have lost a few viewers now. You've been playing there, Tom.
Sorry about that.
We are very, very grateful. I think it's brilliant and amazing the number of people that tune into us live. And we really, really do appreciate you watching our videos.
We do.
And if you can click on the like and the subscribe button.
And buy this organ. What?
Because, there's 124 people watching, only 42 likes. Find that like button.
Here we go.
Probably the rest of them are dislikes and they don't show up. So.
Yes. No, don't show them that.
So that was the interesting thing that YouTube did about a year ago. There was a big uproar because they took away visually how many dislikes a video had.
Yeah.
So you could see how many likes it had, but not how many dislikes. Now the person that puts the video up could look behind the scenes and see how much people dislike what you're doing. Yeah. But it's not shared with the general world. So Graham Williams says, what are the long wave sounds as mentioned on the specs for the pre-owned OAX100 Black? That's a good question, actually. Funnily enough, we were talking about this before we came up.
You were. I was listening. Yes.
So over the history of sampled sounds, there have been various cheats that the engineers have used to produce a sampled sound from as little as possible. And that's because the resources that the engineers had when sampled sound first came out was really limited, because a sampled sound is literally the recording of the instrument.
Yes.
So rather than it being synthesized, they would actually make a physical recording of a piano going dong, and they would use that to recreate the sound of a piano on the organ or the keyboard or the synthesizer. But of course, they had limited resources. One, they didn't have much memory. They didn't have very fast processors. They had all kinds of constraints that we kind of take for granted now. But back then, they had this real trouble with, once you record an audio sound as a piece of data, it's a very large amount of data. Well, back then it was a ridiculous amount of sound. To kind of put it into comparison, we used to use floppy disks.
Yes.
And probably an entire floppy disk would take about 4 seconds of audio data.
Yeah.
So it was a lot of data. So they had to find ways of not using so much data. And so they used to cheat.
Be creative.
Yes, absolutely. Yes. What they used to do, for example, with a piano sound, is a piano sound is actually recognizable by the percussion bit at the bottom, the dong.
Yes.
So what they would do is only sample the d of the dong. Even shorter than that. It was literally the duh. And then that was enough for you to recognize it as a piano. And then, of course, the rest of the piano sound, if Tom holds the note down, is this kind of tone.
Which slowly decays.
So what they used to do was actually just take a little segment of that sound, of that and loop it over and over and over and over, and then just gradually fade it out. and so they could get away with making something that sounded like a piano just by recording a tiny, tiny bit and then using that bit repeated over and over to make the whole length of the sound, rather than having to do like a 5 or 6 second sample.
Which that is.
So when we talk about long wave samples now, we're talking about them actually sampling the whole note. So it's the whole note being played rather than them synthesizing half the note. In fact, Yamaha used to do a system, they called it the Dual Architectural Synthesis System. How about that, if you remember an acronym? It's called DAS.
DAS.
And that was in the early days of sampling. Again, they did the same thing. They used a sample for the very first part of the sound, and then they used FM synthesis to actually produce the rest of it to fill in the gap. Because actually for your brain, and actually for a lot of instruments, it's actually that initial attack
That
makes it sound realistic. Mm. After you've had the initial attack, most instruments go into a repeating cycle of a tone. But it's the initial attack which is the very important part of it. So that's what we mean by long wave, is they've actually sampled the whole sound. There's no cheating going on.
So if I do that with that piano.
Yeah. That's why it sounds so much more realistic. Because a lot of people say... So a lot of people, you know, when they say, well, if you recorded the sound, you recorded the sound.
Yeah.
But they haven't necessarily recorded all the sound. They've only had to record a tiny bit of it.
Okay.
And of course, the other bit we were talking about is the fact that they didn't necessarily, back in those days, sample every single note.
No.
In fact, they would only sample about two or three of them. That's how limited they were. Mm. And to make the other notes, they would speed up and slow down the one that they did record. And because the rest of it was being synthesised, it didn't matter so much. So, lots of cheating
lots
going
of
on.
That.
No more cheating anymore, though.
No.
So the beauty of it is that on every Wersi OAX model, being an OAX1, a 500, 600, 700, 800, 900, and a Pergamon, it's the same sample set.
Yes.
So same quality of sound from all the instruments. And especially on this Mahogany wooden one, which definitely sounds better.
It's actually an incredibly rare thing to get in. Pre-loved.
Key says, I've only got a subscribed button. Oh, okay. Maybe you've already liked. Do you know, actually, since we said that, the likes have jumped up to 67. So thank you, everybody.
Bravo.
Because funnily enough, it really does help for our videos being shared outside the people that are watching live. So that's brilliant. Kevin Hall says, hey, bring back the valves, I say. Kevin Williams. This applies to all OAXs then. Yes. Keys, I think it was the FX series when Yamaha introduced that feature. The drums feature. Yeah, it was definitely, the FX had the swing, because if you wanted the traditional kind of doom, 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 crash, bang, wallop thing, you had the bounce style that they called
it. Yes, that's right,
And then you had, I mean, the reason why they were suddenly able to do that is because on that FX series, they had AWN drums. They were sample drums.
Right.
It all fits in, you see.
Okay.
And so the reason why drums are easier to sample is because a drum is a very short sample. If you hit a bass drum, it's a dum. A snare is a t. You haven't got to worry about it being different pitches, different notes.
No.
So it was the easiest for them to start off with by producing sample drum sounds. And they had a cymbal sound that went ting and so forth.
Yeah, that's it, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's it, isn't it?
Look at that showing off there.
But even then, if you make the recording of the drum, it makes it better, doesn't it?
Yeah. Oh, well, I mean, this is the thing, is that was all the early days. Now, they come up with all kinds of clever things. I mean, Yamaha have their Revo drums. Mm. And also a big thing now is that everything is sampled in stereo. Again, everything back then was sampled in mono. So when they went to stereo, you doubled the amount of workload because you've got to do a left and a right, recording as well. Why don't we play something with the piano? Because the piano is probably the benchmark for sampling because everybody knows what a piano should sound like. And we do have one of the best pianists sitting at this bench in the country.
Where is he here? Is he here? I can't find him. I better put my my foot switch on.
Ah, yeah.
Sustain.
I've done a video about that recently.
You did, didn't you? Yes.
There we go. We've got a nice shot of the two keyboards there. Because actually, one of the nice features of the 800 series is having two 76 note keyboards. With this lovely Fatah.
Get it right.
Keyboard, which is beautiful to play as a piano.
It's lovely, isn't
so
it?
So Tom has now assigned the sustain, the damper pedal, to his left foot switch.
I'm also just...
fiddling here. So I'm going to waffle a bit more.
You do waffle, yeah. I thought about putting a nice little...
bit of strings behind it?
Well, yeah. I was going to go... The, do a little...
electric piano.
Bit of electric piano.
Like that, yeah.
Or maybe we need a... bells. That's the one. There we go.
Yeah,
and then we put on the foot switch, all manual.
So this is the thing, you can do it all lines. Oh, look at that.
That's
gorgeous.
Nice.
things I do. That's beautiful, Tom. I love about
size,
playing piano and organ notes, being able to add a bass note as well. That you can put like a bowed string in there. And so give it that extra sort of foundation. It's one of the unique things about you can play that piano style and add.
Because you can put it on the pedal, you can put them on the thing. Now, if I wanted to put that strings on the thing, I could just bring another sound in. And so this is the great thing with
Maybe you can make a copy of it, Tom. Do you remember?
Well,
remember
I was wondering that. Yeah, I did think about
that. Use your two fingers and you make a copy.
Put the right chord in. That would
This song. I like this song.
That's
we'll fly again.
One day I'll fly one away. Yeah.
I love the version of that from Moulin Rouge.
Oh,
yeah.
With Nicole Kidman.
She sings that really well. But the orchestration that whoever did the orchestration for, I can't remember his name now, Scottish composer. Who did the Love Actually music?
Yes,
Craig Armstrong.
Craig Armstrong.
The orchestral arrangement he did was gorgeous.
It's very well done, really. Yeah, it's a lovely piece. Randy Crawford. Yeah, brilliant.
I was just adjusting the camera there because somebody did. Paul did ask, how do you get the sustain pedal on the piano? Let's have a shot of the screen and then Tom can show us exactly how he did that.
Have we got?
There we go.
We have.
One screen. There we go.
So I'm going to take my grand piano. Time for my next drink. And then I'm going to go settings. Foot switches on page one, and then I can put it on the left kick switch. I've got sustain on all manuals, or if I want to, sometimes sometimes it's a bit easier to do it on a foot piston.
Actually, funny enough, we were talking about this just the other day. So some of the smaller Wersis, which don't have a 25 note pedal, have what looks like a piano pedal sticking out. And if you want to assign it to there, if you assign it to piston number 5, it goes on that foot switch.
Absolutely.
And on the Wersi, you do have the option to store it, to have the sustain just working on one manual. We don't need to sustain
that's
more.
Right.
So you can sustain the upper or just the lower.
Because at the moment.
Or both of them, yeah.
That's on both, so I can
just
say.
So you don't really want to sustain the trumpet, for example. No. So you can just set it to the lower.
Sustain lower. And then you can even make your own templates for the buttons.
Yeah,
I am.
So the hour has actually whizzed by. as it always does. Thank you everyone for watching. So I don't know if I actually mentioned explicitly, but this, what makes this particular OAX800 very, very exciting, not just because it's in this beautiful mahogany finish.
I've just played it.
And Tom has now played it, so you know. it is that it's actually a pre-owned model.
It is.
So if you're looking for, if you wanted an 800, especially in this wooden finish, then, and you may think a new one was out of your budget, this is a pre-owned model.
Yes.
So give us a call, have a look on the website. The instrument is all
lots
on there.
Of lovely pictures,
lots of pictures of it.
The thing I love about it is the fact that they put a charcoal.
Yeah, I said that at the beginning.
It's beautiful,
it's
isn't it?
The
touch is
charcoal.
Lovely.
I said it was brown, but charcoal would be grey.
It would, wouldn't it? Is that
or
grey?
Black.
Chocolate then, dark chocolate. Yeah. Anyway, yes.
with the silver writing on it.
Indeed,
it
very,
yes, very nice.
Yes, lovely accents.
So Peter Brown says many thanks for a great demo, the fantastic sounds of the Wersi. Yeah, it's a pleasure.
Yeah,
we enjoyed it today. Graham Williams, such a great hour again. Thank you. Yeah, well, we enjoy, and we are very, very grateful for everybody that tunes in to watch us every week. It's fantastic to think that there's over 100 people out there all around the world who have stopped what they're doing to listen to us. So thank you very much, guys. And as I say, if you'd like to learn more about this wonderful pre-owned 800,
absolutely,
give us a call in the shop, give us an email, or visit the website, yes, allensmusiccentre.co.uk.
Phenomenal part exchanges available.
Absolutely.
Yes.
If you've got a smaller Wersi, this is your chance to upgrade to an 800. Oh, Tom's getting himself ready. What are we going to have to finish off with?
Well, I thought we'd sit with the piano
sit
to
with
finish
the piano,
off.
A bit of jazz. Yeah, you see. Yeah. Okay, thanks everybody for watching, and we will say goodbye and leave you with Tom doing jazz.